Hi friends, myself Ram Kumar. Today we are discussing about the process studio, which is the component available under Blue Prism tool, which is used for configuring the business process which needs to be automated. Okay, so let's get started. So under this process studio, we will be learning about what is the objective of this process studio, what is our objective, and then what we aim at, and means end of this learning, what we will see. What are the basic skills required, means how the process studio is looking like, what are the keys available, such kind of things we will be seeing. Okay, followed by what are the data items and data types, means which will be used for storing the data, and then we can be used internally to the process. And then what are the stages available in process studio, which and how we can use them. And then we will see how to run a process and then how to validate a process as well. So once we have configured a process, we have to do the validations also before running it. Okay, and then what is a circular path, so what are the controlling play keys which are available, and then how we can deal with it, and then what is breakpoints, so how we can use collections inside loops. Okay, and then what is a page and when to use a page reference, where to use, and then stepping in pages, means how we can go through a page or a section of a process and then how we are going to deal with it. And the control room, where how we can run a process from a control room. So these all we will be seeing in this process studio module. Let's get started. So what is the objective? So objective is, first we need to understand or explore the process studio, right? And then we have to know how to create a new process, and then how we can manage it, and what are the stages which are available in process studio, and then how we are able to map it for our business process configuration. So let me show you how to create a new process. So I'm in process studio tab, and then if you see here, there is something called process, under which I will say right click and I will say create process, right? So I will say something like read Excel. So this is my process name, I want to keep it. So this is how you will give it. Click on next tab, and then you have to give a description, meaningful description for your own to understand what is the business process is all about. So read student data from Excel and store it, right? So this is our process which we want to do. So we will be going through each and every topic with an example, and then we will see how the features are there and how it is. So the same process which is simply doing, we are doing now, right? So we'll make it step by step, we will enhance it so that it becomes into a complete process, like example reading data somewhere, uploading the data into somewhere else, and then gripping data from any web application, and then how we process it. Those all we'll be seeing, and then we'll be seeing the step by step increments on top of it. So starting with, we are just starting a process, something like this, right? So we have got a process name now, so I'm double clicking it. So once we double click it, so this is the process configuration or workplace where we can start working on configuring our process, right? So this is, so by default you'll be getting something called start and end. So this is by default which we'll be getting, and then if you see here, there is a information box, which we call this as information box. Okay, so the read Excel is the process name, and this is the description name, read student data from Excel and store it, right? This is what which we have created. When it is created, those all data will be stored here. So this is like a information box. Okay, on the left pane, if you see here, there are, these all are called stages. So I was telling you, right, how to use stages, and then how we can use the stages to complete our process, to configure our process, to make a step-by-step procedure of each process. And then I was telling you something like page reference. So these are all the stages actually. So we will see each one and everything and in detail with an example, and then we will learn how to make use of them. So this is how a process is being created, and then we will see what are the what are the next stages are available, and then we will pull in one by one stage, and then we will see how we can configure them into our process. Let's go back to the PPT. So we have seen the objective and then how to create a new process, and then what are the various stages available in the process. So next is, you should know, understand, like some basic skills are required. So the process diagrams are comprised of various stages connected together using links to form a logical structure. So I will show you how to connect different stages in the tool. So this is what we will be learning now. And then stages are selected from the toolbar and placed onto the diagram using the mouse. So I will show you this as well, means how to. So we have seen many stages on the left, right. So based on our main need, so what is the type of step which we are selecting, based on that we will pull this particular stage onto the grid, and then we will be connecting using links. So that also we will be seeing it practically. And then they can be like, the stages can be selected, moved, resized, formatted, cut, copied, pasted, deleted. So this is what you are expecting, right? So we can play with the stages in any manner, and then you can have it work around, and then we can see how these are very much useful for us. So links are created using the link tool by dragging the mouse from center of the one stage to the center of the another. So this we'll be seeing practically now. So let's go back to the tool. So the first thing is link, which we are talking about, right? So the default it is pointer. So when you are selecting link, if you see here on the mouse, we are something getting tagged to it. So it is showing the link diagram, means so any link can be drawn. Example, I am saying that the process start is getting started and it will end. So mine is an empty process now, right? Hope you are understanding. So every process, when you run it, it will have a start, it will have an end. So now what I did is, when I am connecting start to end, means I have just made a empty process. But this is not our the requirement which we want to do, right? If any stage we want to do, example, there is a decision stage. We will go in detail how the decision stage works, but just I am dragging it so that you will understand. So I have filled this decision stage, and then if you see here, I can make it big size, I can change the name of it, okay, and I can cut and copy and paste it. So this is what they are telling, right? So this is how it works actually. So you can, so if I will reduce the size, okay, I will reduce the size, and then how it is linked, okay. So if you see here, a decision box can be linked like this, and then from decision box, where the control, so the arrow shows us from where the control is going, means it is getting from started, it went to decision box, okay. So I will delete this and then keep one more, say something like calculate. So from start, I will link to calculate. Inside calculate, what I will do, we will explain you when we are going through this stage in detail. For now, you should understand how I am doing the linking. That's where our objective is. So these basic skills are how to get a stage onto the grid. You can use this, and then you can copy one of, example, you want multiple calculations. So right, I will select this, Control C, Control V. So I'll be getting one more. So we can do this, and then you can delete it after selecting it, right? You can have two calculations also simultaneously. And then what I can do is, I will again have a link, pull it, and this, and then for the sake of beautification, I will make it something like this. So I can make my process very beautiful. So I can keep the end also next to start. So it depends, right? You can configure how you like. So these are something like, which is plug and play. I think you understand, right? Plug and play means you are just pulling the stage, corresponding stage here, and then you are linking it. So what is configured in the calculation is different thing. So for time being, you understand, this is how we do the linking, right? Yeah. So now we have seen this kind of basics links now. Now we will understand, for the calculation or decision, anything to happen, we need to give some input data to it, right? That is the primary thing. So for any process to complete, it needs some input, and it might give some output. So this kind of input and output data are stored where? Those are data items actually, right? So data items, are nothing but variables which we can hold data in a text format, number format or a date format and something like this. So we have the list of data types I have listed here. So which is number, which is used for storing number value, text for using alphanumeric or anything in the form of text can be stored in this data type, flags which have true and false, false values actually, date. So there are different types of formats inside the date, but for your understanding it has the date, complete date object can be stored in a date object. Password, for any sensitive information we have it here. Okay, so just we will just see how we can create a data item in the process studio and how we can have an initial value set to it. Okay, so let me go back to the process studio. So this is the process studio, right? Create some variables here. So this is the data item. So this is a stage. This is one kind of stage. So what I am doing is I am pulling one stage here, and then the date, the name of the data item is date one. It is the name of the variable. We did not select the type of the variable. So there are two things. The name which is there here, it is something like counter, I will say. So counter is the name of the variable. Description, what you should do is counter for sample usage. So you have to give a meaningful description here, and then data type which is telling. So as it is a counter, I think you must be understanding it should be of a number format. Right? There are many types of these all types of data types which we'll be using one by one. We will go through each one of them, and then you will have a clear understanding of what data can be used at which place, right? And then if you see here, once I selected the number, it is asking for what is the initial value you want to keep. So example, I want to start the counter from 1000. So we can have the initial value as 1000. So after using this counter variable in a calculation or an expression, this value can be modified accordingly. Right? If you are from a programming background, I think you will be definitely understanding what is a variable and how we can use. If you are from a non-programming background, just understand that you are having some initial value to a variable, and then this is storing means the counter, the data item name is counter, it is of number type, and then it is having initial value of 1000, which can be modified in the later point of time in the process, right? And then when you can see some fields like this, hide from other pages and this thing, these all things can be explained when we are seeing multiple pages on our main process studio. So for now we have only one page which is called main page on our process studio. So we will discuss this at a later point of time, and then exposure, something like can we make this global, can we make this static, can we make this session variable, right? So this all will be learning. Once we get that kind of feature, when we get into such kind of scenario, I will explain you how to use them in then real time, right? So for now, just we have created a variable and then we are storing this. If you see here, so this symbol shows this is an input item. If you know a flow diagram, normal flow diagram, so this is a input item. So this is the symbol for a input item, means so it is having some data and then for a particular type. And then we have initialized it to some value as 1000. Okay. So if you want to, the one more thing you have to understand is we should not link this data item, means we cannot create a link. Example, I will take this counter to the start, near to the start, and then I will use the link now. If you see here, I am dragging the link, but when I am releasing it, it's not able to link it. But if you take a care of calculation, right? So if you see now, I am pulling the link from start to calc 1. It got connected. Cal 1 to cal 2 connected. Cal 2 to end connected. Cal 1 to counter, I am saying it would not be connecting, because data items are such kind of items in the process studio which will be floating, means there will be not be any linking to it. You should understand this. These are like variables which are standing apart, and these variables will be used by this process in its place. Okay, so these are the, so if you want to have a text, so I need to pull one more item. So now I am saying text, I want to have something like it's a name. So variable to hold name value, right? So this I have created to have a, so what is the type we'll give for a name? We'll give a type as text. Initial value, I am keeping it empty, or I will be keeping something like RAM, right? And this is, okay, with no need of double quotes actually, as we are saying text, we can give it directly, okay? So this is how we give it, and then this value is stored. So if you see here, I have two data types. So by seeing this, you will not be not getting what is the data type, you will be seeing only the value, right? So once you want to see what is the data type, once you double click it, you will see what is the data type. So, right, okay. So these are the kind of data types we have, and then we'll be creating a complete process, and then we will make sure each and every type of data is used, and then you will have a feel of it. Okay, so let's go back to the PPT again. We are done with the data types, and then what are data types and types, right? So we will see what is the next here. So we have something called stages. So a decision stage. So decision stage is tool which is used to decide the two possibilities of a certain steps in a program. Means you are going through a program, and then you have something like you take a decision. If the number is less than something, take a root one, go to the path of one, and then if the value is greater than some value, x value, you have to take a second route. So the decision is giving a control in which path it has to pick, and then the control should flow in which diagram actually, right, which direction. So it has two outbound links and then one inbound link. Means when the control is coming inside the decision box, right, some decision is happening here. Based on the true and false flag, means based on the result of the expression, the corresponding value will be picked up. So we will go back to the process studio and see how we can have a decision box inside this. Let's go back to the tool. So if you see here, so instead of this calculation, what I will do is I will remove this for now, and then I will bring a decision stage. So what I will see is check counter. So this is what I am doing. Okay, so description is check if the counter value is greater than 100. So this is some condition I want to do. So if you see here, so we have created two data types. One is a number of name counter, and one is the name. So this is the explorer of a data item, where a stage where we can use the data items to form an expression, and then the result will be stored accordingly. So decision box will have an input. Input is based on the data types or the data items which we have, an expression is created, and the result of the expression is stored or used by the decision to go into the which direction. Okay, we will see this. So what is the condition we thought? Whether the counter value is greater than 100 or not. So what should we keep? So I am dragging the counter onto the expression panel. I am leaving it here, and then I am saying if it is greater than 100. So I will not, so you have to understand what the thing is. This expression, I am not storing the value anywhere. The value will be generated by the system, and then will be based on it the yes and no flow direction will be picked up accordingly. Okay, let's see this, how this expression is going to work now. Okay, I will say okay, and then what I will do is I will use a calculation here. Okay, so this is for yes stage. If the decision is yes, what I want to do, increment, or what I will do is, okay, we will use another data item. We will take empty, or you have the name, right? So what I will do is, if it is named, I will assign some value to this name. So if it is greater than 100, what I am saying is I want to assign some value to the string. So what I am saying is, entered value is greater than 100. So this addition we got. Okay. So this is true case. So this is the name of the calculation which I kept. So what I am doing is, this expression value, this string value, I am storing it name. Earlier we have kept something like RAM inside it. So I am editing the value. Okay. So if it is false case, means I will do a copy paste here. So I will say it is false case. So false case, what I will say is, enter value is less than 1000. I am storing the same variable if you see now. Okay. So now I will connect the dots. Just keep a watch on it. So first thing is, when the start is coming in, so the control is going to the check counter stage. From there, the first link will be yes, means if the value is greater than 100, this will be called else. I want to call this false stage. I will just reorganize it. I will bring the false below it. Okay, and then I will link it again. After false or true, we are just going to close it up. So this is our process ready, means we have initial value of counter. What we are doing is, we are checking for the counter if the decision or if the condition is true. If else condition, right? If the if is true, it will go to this calculation which is called as true case, and then it will assign some value into the name field. If it is false, it will come to the false case calculation, and then it will assign some value to the name field. So this is how we do the decisioning. So let's go back to the PPT. So we have seen here how to configure our decision stage. Okay. Now we will move on to the next stage, which is calculation. I think we have already seen this calculation stage, which is aiming at calculating the value and store it in a data item same as variables. So calculation stage needs to retain the result of its expression. This we have already seen, right, where in a decision we are giving an expression and the result is not stored anywhere. The Blue Prism tool itself will pretend or store the value inside, and then based on the value it is true or false, it is taking the direction of the flow, right? Calculation, but is not like that. So once some expression is given, and then the result of the expression is stored in some variable. So similar like we have seen, right, we have given some string values, and then the value of the string is stored into the name data type. So we have seen this stage as well. Okay. So this action stage, for now we will just park it. So this allows you to use a business object in a process. Okay. Thing that I was telling you, right, Excel sheet has a read option, write option, something like this. So read is an action, write is an action. So once we configure the object studio or objects in the object studio, you will be able to use the actions inside the process by using this action stage. Okay. We will have a look at this in the tool, but from theoretical perspective, just understand that we have an action stage in which we will be able to map to the action in an object, so that the particular action or an event on an application can be interacted. So next is, we need to know how to run a process. Okay. So whenever a code is written in any language, we first run it to do a check and then desired workflow, and same thing is applied for Blue Prism process. So once you are done with your configuration, if you see here in the earlier screen where I have shown you, we have taken a decision box, done some calculation, and then we went to the end. So from start to end, that is the complete process, step by step process, and then we are ready with the process, means we have configured the process. Now we need to get to know how to run this, means how to trigger the process to get started, and then we can see how it is running, and then we, once it reaches to the end, the byproduct will be ready. Okay. So in process studio we can run it, and then we can observe it running. That's what it is saying. Okay. So we have a toolbar. which provides the commands or which is used for triggering a process. Means when you have done the development, we can run the process, execute the process from a control room, that is a different thing. But when you are developing it, you need to know how to trigger our process which is configured and then understand how it is running. You have to test it once, right? So that we can do using this commands which are there on the screen. So we will see, we will explore where these commands are there in our process studio. Okay, and then next we will, what we will do is once we have run a process, there might be some errors which we have configured. So you need to understand how to validate your process, right? So this is the functionality which is there also in process studio, where we have something called check process. So which will be giving this, and then it will be giving the count of errors. Once you click on that count of errors, you will be able to point to the stage from where we are getting this. This is what we can do it check now. So let's go back to the tool and then understand how we can start a process. Before starting a process, how we can check for a process validation, and then how can fix the immediate errors which are there. So this is our process, and let's run this, and then we will see how to run this. If you see here on the left top, we have these functions, right? So we have these buttons. So this is go button which is there to initiate the or trigger the process to start with. Okay, there are pause buttons, there are stop buttons, there are refresh buttons. We will get to know when they are running. So before running a process, once you feel like you have completed your process, you need to validate this. If you see here, by default it is saying there is some one error actually. This is what I am checking, where the process, it has validated earlier. So I will do a refresh here. So this refresh button, if you have made any changes to the links or something, it will not be reflecting immediately. So you have to say refresh. So when I say refresh, the errors became zero. I am double clicking it and I will see that there are no errors, right? What I will do is, I will miss one link here. I will remove one link here. Means after the true calculation is done, next the control is not knowing where to go. Means the Blue Prism tool will not understand after the calculation is over for the success scenario where the control should go. So we have to plan, or we have to configure in such a way that everything is ending with the end stage. We have to make a note of this. You cannot leave this in air or blank like this. So if I refresh the process studio, you will see that there is one error. So this is the basic validation the process studio is doing for you, and it is want to alarm you. What is saying is, the page name is main page, and then it is a true case. Stage name is true case. This is the name which we have given to the, what is the name we have given to the calculation, if you remember. For the calculation stage, we have given a name. So the name is true case. So the name is displayed here. Okay, what is the type? Error. What is the description of the error? It is a missing link. Okay, if I double click this, and then I will say go to stage at the bottom. If you see, I have selected it, and then I am saying go to stage. So what it will do is, the control will highlight in a yellow color. If you see here, means this is the stage where which is causing the problem. I am closing the validation thing, and then what I will do is, now I will see that the link is connected. So to run it, what I said, we just need to click on go. I am clicking on it, and let's see. So it is checking over. If you see here, what happened is, we will just run in very slow mode for you to understand. So again, I am refreshing it. So I will do a refresh and then start. So if you see a start, it went to checkation box, it is checking, and then went to the calculation box, it has done the calculation, assigned the value. Earlier, if you see here, the value earlier was name was Ram was there. But if you see here, there are two things. If you see here, I will see the initial value which is kept to the variable is Ram. But once the process is done, what is the current value? Right? I think you understand, right? What is initial value and current value? Before the process is getting started, if there are any default values given, that will be as initial values. But if when we are assigning, means once the calculation stage is completed, we have assigned one value to this, and then this value is being stored into the variable now. So once you use this variable anywhere, example you are using this name variable in the next set of your process, the value will be this one, the current value will be picked up in the process, not the initial value. When there is no current value, initial value will be picked up. Okay, if there is no initial value also, empty value will be picked up. So that is how it works. So what I will do is, instead of 100, 1000, I will make it 0. You know, right, what is the condition we have kept? The condition we have kept is it should be greater than 100. So I made it, so I will make it 99. Let's see how it will work when I make it 99. Okay, refresh. And now I will run this, make sure, just see how it runs now. So it is coming to the decision box. 99 is less than 100, so it came to the false block. So now you have to see what is the value of in the data item. The data item is having the value of entered value is less than 100. So this is how simply we can work on with the process. And one more thing is, if you see here on the status bar on the top, the process studio, it is completed. Once the process control reaches to the end stage, means the process will stop here and then it will give a flag called completed. But if you see here, there are some variables values to the data items. To reset this, you have to click on refresh button. Okay, we will work on how to pause a process when we are actually having a big process in place, right? Keep learning. Thanks for watching.